Hello everyone, my name is Ankit Kumar and in my last video I talked about my interview and my assessment experience for a specialist programmer role at Infosys. In this video, I'm going to talk about the training process that you will go through if you get selected in Infosys. So I recommend you to watch this video if you are going to be part of the training, because in this video I'm going to discuss all the important things like your pre-test, your stream selection, your client interview or other things that you should know if you are going to be part of training or if you are currently a part of training, so that your training journey will be more easier. I will also discuss my own experience so that you can gain some knowledge from that and apply it during your training to make it more smoother and more easier for you. So before starting about telling about the training, let me tell you first some point, like some general points. The first thing is that your training is going to be in Mysore. And yes, the Mysore campus is really beautiful. Second, they are going to pay you your complete salary. Third, that the training is going to be easy if you give your sufficient amount of time. So I have all the points written here. I will discuss each and everything one by one. So if you get your selection mail from the Infosys, they will also tell you to come with some important document. And the document vary year to year, but there are some mandatory documents that you have to. So I will provide the list of all the document in the link of this video or the description of this video. Now, if you are inside the Mysore campus, the first thing is your induction program that is going to be for 4.5 days. And in the induction program, they will tell you about the rules and regulation of the company. And they will also provide you the welcome kit. And I recommend you to listen them carefully, because Infosys is strict towards its rules, regulations and policies. After the induction program, there will be a pretest, and they will tell you that based on the pretest, they are going to decide your streams. Now, what is streams? So once you are part of Infosys, they are going to train you on streams, means streams like Java, React, .NET, Big Data, and there are multiple streams in the Infosys. So they will tell you that based on your pretest, they are going to decide your stream. But as per my experience, there is no impact of the pretest on your stream selection. Most probably, they will provide your stream randomly. When you got your stream, once you got your classroom, after that your actual training will start. And your training is going to be divided into two parts. The first one is behavior skills, and the second one is your core stream training. The duration of the complete training is 49 days, including your induction program. 4.5 days of induction program, 4.5 days of behavior skills training, and 40 days is for your stream training. And this 49, like total 49 days, is 49 working days. If I give you a reference for our batch, so my batch started on 8th of July and it's completed on 10th of October. So it took 95 days. So once your training gets started, the first thing is your behavior skill training. To pass your behavior skill, you have to score 65%, overall 65% marks. And the total mark is divided into two categories. The first one is 20% weightage for your BCEP course. They will provide you a course and tell you to complete it. And you will get approximately 1.5 months to complete that particular course. And it's easy to complete that course also. And I also recommend you to complete the course completely, because from there you will get your 20% mark, 20 mark out of 100. And the rest 80% is MCQ. You are going to appear in an MCQ test that has a negative marking. So you have to be careful about that. If I have to give you any tips for your BCP or for your complete behavior skills. So for BCP, as I told that I recommend you to complete the whole course. And second, for MCQ test, I will tell you to listen to your teachers, because I feel that the teacher that will teach you your behavior skill, that will teach you soft skill, is really good. So if you just carefully listen them, and before 1 or 2 days of your examination, if you complete the assessment, there are assessment present on the Lex. Now, what is the Lex? So it is a learning platform of Infosys. They will give you the access of this particular platform. So if you complete the assessment from the Lex of each and every courses, so it is easier for you to complete the behavior skill training. You will easily get more than 65% marks. Now, after the behavior skill, your main training will start. Or like, is training mein aapko आपके कोर सब्जेक्ट्स पे. लाइक इन माय केस माय कोर सब्जेक्ट इज जावा रिएक्ट. सो इन माय केस दे टीच मी अबाउट जावा स्प्रिंग बूट एंड रिएक्ट. सो इसमें आपको आपके कोर सब्जेक्ट के बारे में ट्रेनिंग दी जाएगी एंड द असेसमेंट इज गोइंग टू बी इन थ्री डिफरेंट पार्ट द FA1, FA2 एंड FA3. द पैटर्न ऑफ FA1 एंड FA2 इज क्वाइट सिमिलर. नॉट क्वाइट सिमिलर, इट इज सिमिलर. द पैटर्न ऑफ FA1 एंड FA2 इज सिमिलर. 40% of weightage of FA1 is for the MCQ questions, and that MCQ is again negative marking. The 60% is hands-on examination. Hands-on examination means you have to write code. It's a kind of coding practice. Okay. For MCQ question, again I am telling, जो भी लेक्स में आपका MCQ question, MCQ assessment present होंगे, try to complete it and try to get knowledge from it. You will find your actual MCQ test easier after completing those. Second. For hands-on examination, try to get understanding of the concepts, try to listen in the class carefully, and if you have a basic understanding, not basic, I will say, if you have a medium level of understanding of your subject, like in my case Java, if you have a medium understanding of Java, Spring Boot or what they are teaching in the class. And second thing, before each and every examination, they will conduct a mock test. And aapko mock test mein jarur participate karna hai, because jo question patterns mock test mein hoga, wahi same pattern आपके एक्चुअल टेस्ट में भी होगा. लेवल ऑफ क्वेश्चंस भी सेम होंगे, मींस डिफिकल्टी लेवल भी सेम होंगे, बट नंबर ऑफ टेस्ट केसेस विल बी मोर. सो आई रिकमेंड यू टू पार्टिसिपेट इन द मॉक टेस्ट फॉर योर हैंड्सन एग्जामिनेशन, और साथ ही साथ ट्राई टू लिसन योर टीचर्स, ट्राई टू गेट अ मीडियम लेवल ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द कंसेप्ट. देन आपके लिए काफ़ी ईजी हो जाएगा हैंड्सन क्लियर करना और MCQ क्लियर करना. एंड देर इज नो लाइक आपको MCQ में इतना मार्क्स लाना ही है, आपको हैंड्स ऑन में इतना मार्क्स लाना ही है, नो, नथिंग लाइक दैट. यू टोटली यू हैव टू स्कोर ग्रेटर देन 65%. ओके, लेट मी टेल दिस मोर इन मोर क्लियर वे. सो फॉर FA1, FA2 एंड FA3, योर एग्रीगेट लाइक योर एवरेज मार्क्स मस्ट बी ग्रेटर देन 65, और इन ईच एंड एवरी असेसमेंट लाइक इन FA1, इन FA2 एंड इन FA3 सेपरेटली यू हैव टू स्कोर ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 50%. ओके, सो I already told you about the pattern of FA1 and FA2, that 40% is for MCQ, and MCQ is negative marking, the 60% is for hands-on, for FA1 and FA2, and for FA3, there is the division of 30% and the 70%, 30% is for MCQ, the MCQ is of negative marking, again the same rule apply here, आपको बस जो लेक्स पे MCQ assessment है, उसको करके जाना है, that's enough, means not enough I will say, but you will get an understanding that what kind of question they are going to ask. The next 70% is based on your project. So FA3 में आपका कोई examination नहीं होगा, like there is no any hands-on examination in FA3. आपको एक project allot किया जाएगा, like you have to complete that project, and आप उसमें अकेले नहीं होंगे. There are multiple people in your group. Probably there are 2 people or 3 people also in your group, and आप दोनों और आप तीनों को मिलकर एक particular project को complete करना होगा. And after completion of your project, there will be an virtual interview with the STG team. Now what is the STG team? So in Infosys, STG, you can understand it's a technical. Like if you are selected for the specialist programmer role, you are also a part of STG team. So aapke hi seniors honge, jo ki aapka interview lenge for that particular project. And the interview is going to be easy. Believe me, it is going to be easy. Bas jo bhi aap project kar rahe ho, aapko project ka achche se understanding hona chahiye. Aur jo bhi aapko padhaya ja chuka hai, uski basic understanding hona chahiye. They are going to ask questions based on your code, based on your project. और साथ ही साथ वो आपको प्रोजेक्ट का आउटपुट लाइक दे विल टेल यू टू शो द आउटपुट ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट एंड बेस्ड ऑन दैट दे विल प्रोवाइड यू द मार्क्स. सो FA3 30% एंड 70%, 30% फॉर MCQ, 70% इज फॉर प्रोजेक्ट एवोल्यूशन. एज आई टोल्ड वंस यू क्लियर योर बिहेवियर स्किल्स और योर स्ट्रीम ट्रेनिंग, आफ्टर दैट यू हैव टू पार्टिसिपेट इन द क्लाइंट इंटरव्यू. एंड इवन इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू क्लियर एनी ऑफ दिस behavior skill or your stream test, you get the chance of like retest, reappear. But I will suggest to clear it in one go, and it is going to be easier. Like you can clear it in one go. So after clearing the both behavior skill and the stream training, aapka client interview hoga, aur client interview mein jo questions aapse puche jayenge, wo theoretical question honge. Like jitna maine dekha hai, they will ask you only the theoretical question. So if I take a case, like if you are also going to assign with the Java React, like mera Java React tha. So let's suppose you have a client interview. So I will recommend you to go on the interview with like not interview it properly, go on the internet and try to search that top interview question of Java React, like top interview question of Spring Boot. You will get top 50 question, top 60 question. Just go through it. Your interview is going to be easier after that. Once your client interview completed and the client is satisfied with your result, then you will get your release mail. And here, when you get your release mail, there are two kind of locations. The first one is your base location. Release mail means आपको Mysore campus छोड़ के कहीं और जाना है. Means your आपका training successfully complete हो चुका है. आप सारे टेस्ट में पास हो चुके हो. अब आपको Mysore campus छोड़ के किसी और campus में जाना है to work on the real project. Okay? So there are two kind of locations. The first one is base location. The second one is your project location. In most of the cases, your project location or your base location is same. But if I talk about my case, मेरे केस में मेरा project location और मेरा base location दोनों different था. Like my base location is in Pune, my project location is in Hyderabad. So when I got released from the Mysore, I am in the Pune for the 7 days. After that, I have to come Hyderabad for my project work. So right now I'm in Hyderabad. I am continuing my work from the Hyderabad only. But most probably आपका जो base location होगा और आपका जो project location होगा वो दोनों same ही होगा. So once you got your project, you will start working on that, and so that's all about the training. If I talk about my experience, so I will say it's good to be a part of the training because Infosys training is really going to teach you a lot. Like jitna aap college mein nahi padhe ho, I will not say 4 year, but jitna aap 6 mahine mein padhte ho college mein, utna aapko 2 mahine mein cover karna hoga. And you have to study. You have to give sufficient amount of time for your self-study also, for your classes also. And it is going to be a good experience, and I will say you will learn a lot. And once you come out of the training, you yourself feel that you have a better understanding of the things. You have a better understanding of the courses. You have a better understanding of the stream, like Java or Big Data, whatever you have. So it is going to be an exciting journey for you. So just go through the journey and try to complete it in one go so that you will get your project earlier and you will got your release mail earlier. So that's all about the training. If you have any other question, you can comment in this video or you can ask me on my social media platform. I will provide the link of my LinkedIn or my Insta in the comment section or in the description of this video. So that's all. Thanks.